There are four general areas of fundraising that, for me as a Democrat, always cause me concern. So are you willing to go on record and say that you won't accept money from the NRA, from charter schools, from Big Sugar, or, now the fourth one eludes me, oh, real estate development?
Well, I tell you what, as a candidate that has received support from everywhere, I am not beholden to any one organization or one individual at all. I have had, as a matter of fact, because of my stances and because of decisions of leadership and courage that I've had to take, my base has just completely ignored me. So when you're in a campaign and you are one that wants good, has a proven record of doing a good job. Because again, check the state of Florida, look up the schools in District 1, and look at their grades. I have no DRF, so I bring results. But because of decisions that I've had to make and stances that I've had to take, teachers union, they argue with me. Teachers union at a school board meeting. Actually, two ladies, I don't know if you remember that article where I said foolishness, that this is a bunch of foolishness, you know why? Two ladies out there in the auditorium wearing blue shirt, union shirts, before they left, they flicked me a bird. So having said that, to answer your question, I can't answer that question.
So you won't go on record and say you won't take money from the NRA?
The NRA has never supported me.
I understand that.
Charter schools have.
I understand that. What I'm asking is, will you make a declaration saying that if they came
to
your door?
I won't take money. I won't take money from the NRA. I don't know the NRA. But the other folks, when people donate to me, let me make it clear, is because they believe in what I'm doing. Not that I'm going to support what they want me to support. That's not the way Susan Valdez rolls, has ever rolled, ever. I have voted against charter schools. As a matter of fact, if you remember when Charter School USA wanted to take MacDill Air Force Base and turn that into a charter school, guess who led the charge not to? Yours truly. Guess who supported charter schools? Guess who supported Susan Valdez for re-election? Charter School USA. Why? Because I'm fair and I call it out. If it's a good charter school, because let me tell you, there are some charter schools that we, the public school system, fail our kids. We do. And that's our ESE population, our most vulnerable children. And guess what? They generate the most money because of all of their needs. Pepin Academy, phenomenal charter school. Why? They cater to the needs of these children that otherwise would fall through the cracks. I'm here for every child. I'm here for every family. Now, the thing is that your base says, we're going this way because we didn't agree with your firing of a lady, although it was the right thing to do, because guess what? The data shows we four, and I'll name them, April Griffin, Cindy Stewart, Sally Harris, and Susan Valdez made a decision to go a different direction with this district was the right thing to do. So leadership, I'll do it all over again. Now, if my teachers union says, gosh, Susan, wow, you were right. That's not gonna happen. And you all know that to win an election, it takes contributions, it takes hard work. This right here is good government. This right here has made tough decisions that have benefited my kids. And that's what I swore to do under oath. And that's what I continue to do until November 6th, that I'm no longer on the school board. The day I become a potted plant, it's time to go home. And I'm not going to be one now, then, tomorrow, or ever. So NRA, absolutely, they've never supported me. I don't even know who to contact in the NRA, nor do I care.
Yeah.
You know, but everything else, if it's going to be for good government, and that's what they're buying. You vote when you support Susan Valdez, you always going to get the truth. You're always going to get real and nothing but it. This is what you see. This is what you get. For 14